5. Now today we will continue the second part and we will know about safety from fire. How we can keep ourselves safe from fire. Domestic fires and kitchen injuries are the most common example of accidents due to carelessness. Most fires occur while working in the kitchen or while using an electric gadget. To prevent this, following instruction should be followed. We should follow some instruction to prevent these accidents. Use proper clothes, duster to hold the hot pot and pans instead of your own clothes. We should hold the hot pot or pans with some proper cloth or instrument. Get all electric gadgets checked from time to time. If a crack is seen in the plastic covering of the wire, get it replaced. If we see any crack in the wire, we should get it replaced immediately. Never keep a kerosene stove on the floor. If it gets knocked off, the oil can get spilled, resulting in a fire. We should not keep a kerosene stove on the floor. We can by mistakenly kick it and all the oil will spill on the floor. If the oil in a pan catch fire, smother the fire by covering the pan. If a oil in a pan can gets fire, we should just immediately cover the pan. Throw some baking soda on the burning oil. Never throw water. It will splitter and oil will spread the fire. We should never throw water on the burning oil. Never wear nylon or other synthetic clothes in the kitchen or while burning crackers. We should never wear nylon clothes because they catch fire very fast. During Diwali, because they catch fire very easily. Cotton clothes are safer to wear. We should always wear cotton clothes while in the kitchen. Now, prevention from fire. How we can prevent ourselves? To keep burning fire needs air. The one method is putting off fire is to cut off the air supply. Means air is needed for burning, and if we will cut off the supply of the air, the fire will automatically stop. Throwing mud or sand over the fire cut off the air supply by covering the subsurface of substance on the fire. We should always try to throw mud or sand on the fire. Why? Because it will automatically stop the supply of air. Pouring water over the fire cools down the burning substance and also cut off its air supply. By pouring water, the fire also gets cut off. Fire caused by electricity can be put off by throwing sand over it. And when we want to put off the electricity, fire caused by electricity, we should always throw sand over it. There is a special fire extinguisher to put off such fire. We get a fire extinguisher to put off these types of fire. A fire extinguisher is a simple device used to extinguish the fire. It cut off the supply of air to the fire. What does it do? It just simply cut off the air supply. Water should never be thrown over the fire caused by electricity. Electricity can flow through water and give an electric shock to the person who touches it. We should never throw water on a fire which is caused by electricity. Why? The current can pass through it and we can also get electric current. Here you can see the fire extinguisher. Never throw water over burning kerosene or petrol. These are lighter than water and float over the water and will continue burning. We should never throw water. Why? Because oil will float on the water and the fire will not stop. In case of fire is severe, call the help. Call 101 and or call a fire brigade. And if there is a severe fire in their house, we should always call a fire brigade. If clothes catch fire, roll on the ground. It cuts off the air supply and the fire will put off. The blanket or rug is available, roll up it and it is more effective. And if by chance your clothes get fire, what should we do? We should simply roll on the ground so that the air supply is cut off and the fire is switched off. Now, first aid. First is the immediate help given to a wounded or injured person before proper medical aids arrive. First aid is the help which is given to an injured person before the doctor arrives. Proper first aid can prevent injuries from getting worse and can sometimes even save lives. And if a proper first aid is given to a person, we can even save the life of a person. Now, what kind of first aid is given to a person who is injured? First is burn. If a burn is minor, put a burn area immediately under the cold water. This will cool the area and prevents the blisters from being formed. As soon as someone gets burned, we should immediately put the hand under the water. A severe burn can result in blisters, and if the burn is severe, then blisters will be formed. Never prick the blisters. We should never prick the blisters. What are blisters? Blisters are, in Hindi we call them chale. If a blister opens, wash the area with soap and water. And if by chance the blister burst opens, we should wash it with soap and water. Cover it lightly with a piece of clean cloth dipped in the solution of baking soda in water and can be applied on the burnt area. And we should put a cloth dipped in the baking soda and water solution. In case of severe burn, the patient should be taken to the doctor immediately. And if the burn is severe, we should immediately call the doctor. Burn due to chemicals such as acid should be washed with plenty of water. This follow the treatment in case of the then follow the treatment of in case of the burn. And by chance, if a person is burned, get burned by the acid, we should wash it very nicely. The rest you will study in the third part.